Hello, this is Aiden. Today, we're going to be taking a look at prop set creation. As the name would suggest, prop sets are a collection of props gathered together as a single object for ease of use. This prop set contains three different tree props. With it selected, I can use the prop point tool to randomly place one of the three tree props from within the set every time I right-click. This allows me to quickly populate the scene with a variety of tree models, making it feel more organic. This same principle applies to the other prop tools. A prop curve drawn with a prop set selected will randomly generate between the three selected props, and will come with a randomize option to scramble the props shown in each spot. The exact same principle applies for the prop polygon tool. Finally, you will notice that both the prop polygon and the prop curve tool feature a bake option. Once you are done editing your props using the attributes within the prop curve or prop polygon tools, you can press the bake button to convert the entire curve or polygon into individual props so that you can edit each prop on a case-by-case basis. Prop spans require a road to be generated on top of, but otherwise largely follow the exact same principles. The other major exception to this is that prop spans are not automatically generated. You must drag either a prop or prop set onto a road in order to generate it. Finally, let's talk about how to make a prop set of your own. Let's say, for example, that I want to fill a scene with palm trees. RoadRunner's asset library already has several palm tree models available, but I don't want to waste time dragging each different looking one into the scene over and over again. Instead, I can right-click New Prop Set to create a new prop set into which I can attach palm tree props, and I will name it now. With that prop set selected, I will now click the Add Prop button several times. That should be enough to start with. Your prop set can contain any number of these prop slots, and you can always add more in later. So don't worry if you fill them up and need to add more props as you go. Adding props to your prop set is a simple process. Click and drag the prop that you wish to add into any of your open prop slots. You can also drag a prop into an already filled prop slot to overwrite that slot. Now, just make sure that your prop set is selected, and you can lay it down just as we did with the previous ones. A final note on prop sets. The portion attribute controls how often a prop appears relative to all other props in the set. This means that at their default 1.0 setting, each prop appears just as often as any other prop. If the portion of this prop was lowered to 0.5, it would appear half as often as all of the props in the set. To reiterate, portion values are relative to each other. A 1.0 value does not mean that a specific prop will appear a specific amount of times within a given area. It means that it will show up more frequently than other props in the prop set if its portion value is higher, and less frequently if it is lower. Right now, this prop set consists of an equal balance between maple trees and hydrangeas. If we increase the portion of hydrangeas to double that of the maple trees, suddenly this prop set contains a lot more hydrangeas. But remember that these values are relative. Doubling the amount of hydrangeas is exactly the same as halving the amount of maple trees. And again, from a vertical view. This is because these values are relative. 0.5 to 1 or 1 to 2, either way, we are telling this prop set that it should contain twice as many hydrangeas as it does maple trees.